Good evening to you, John. Well, many people, not only from South City, but also from North City, came together here at the Tower Grove Baptist Church that you see behind me. Many of them having questions for her, asking her what she is doing to get a handle on crime, especially when it comes to carjackings. And many people tell me it's just a thing that happens a lot in some of the South City neighborhoods. Now, Gardner answered by saying that many of those carjackings, for example, are being committed by juveniles. However, she says her office is also collaborated with the organization Sankofa Unity, which through its diversion program works with at-risk youth and juveniles who are involved with committing these types of crimes or offenses. Now, she also acknowledged that crime is a public health crisis, but she says to change that, it will require working with police to be strategic and encouraging residents to have conversations with Police Chief John Hayden. Now, before the meeting, we got the chance to catch up with some residents who wanted to know how neighborhood associations in collaboration with Gardner's office can work together with law enforcement to help keep individual communities safe.
The one thing we've noticed is there's a lot of speculation in the neighborhood about crime, like when something happens, where did it come from? Where did it, you know, end up? What happened? So our goal with meeting with Kim tonight is to help get more factual information for our neighbors.
The people elected me, and the people have to hold me accountable, and I'm gonna do my job, and I'm gonna hold accountable the criminal justice reforms that we're pushing forward that makes us safe.
Now, the meeting just got over about 20 minutes ago, so we had a quick chance to catch up with Kim Gardner, and we asked her about the Supreme Court denying her appeal to block the grand jury's search warrant. We will have that answer coming up tonight on Fox 2 News at 10 o'clock tonight. For now, we're live in the Shaw neighborhood. Aisha Khan, Fox 2 News.